budget should be approved for construction until the road auditor had gone through it and certified it as safety compliant before it can be approved.
Thank you very much, and I just noted that that perhaps was not just the only reason why we should applaud Engineer Balikin. Also, he drew attention to the fact that Nigeria has provided the lead model, talking about safety on the roads. I thought that also was answered. And if we tie that in with the fact of providing good road infrastructure, providing monitors for the road. Perhaps it's not by accident that the Minister of State Power works at the government agency in charge of roads is here, sitting in for the Vice President is here. And I do know that many administrations, subsequent administrations in Nigeria, have done a lot. He's a gentleman who I know has done quite a lot in driving the policy for good infrastructure, and he joined us for this discussion today, and I'd just like to acknowledge him just by the side of it. And that's a former secretary to the government of the Federation, a former head of service, and the former Minister of Defence, Balu Mahmood Yaya Ahmed. So, in the meantime, I'd like to return to the question of the response regime, which one of the discussants talked about. I think it was Dr. Joe Obumaki who talked about the response regime, having adequate ambulances in the case of accidents. And I'd like you to chip in a little more on that.
Yes, I was making a reference to the fact that if we have ambulance, there will be establishment of a nationwide ambulance service. And this nationwide ambulance service and a dedicated emergency hotline for the fire road safety was informal and extremely limited. So most patients injured on the road were taken either by relatives to facilities where they receive first aid. In 2001, efforts to address emergency trauma gained political support. That's not gained support from the government. So in 2004, the government established a nationwide ambulance service. So it then rose, that's the cases reported, from 205 in 2004 to 8,250. And then the response then decreased from 17 minutes to 13 minutes. So the average time spent in responding, even in 2006, was 19 minutes. And by 2017, it had then decreased. So if we have this nationwide ambulance services, it will help to reduce fatality. There will be less working. And then anyone that suffers, because one split second matters in saving a life. So that is what I also advocate. That such, the moment you gather political will, then have the support of political will. I'm sure such a thing can happen in a country that will help to save lives.
Thank you very much. Well, since Nigeria is providing the lead in this matter, as Engineer Balikin, you see that being introduced in other African countries, West African countries, for instance, where the design of roads, as you did say, should incorporate road auditor and then infrastructure such as ambulances along the highways.
Yes, in the developing world, when it comes to road safety, the same system of which is what is being used now. This is more like looking at prevention than the prescribed action after. That entails the designers looking at or considering all road users. designed for the vehicle. It is important to consider all road users, from the vehicle to the normal, to the tricycle, to the pedestrian, to all users. So it is important that if we have to save life, that this is incorporated. And how do we incorporate it into our design? This is where road auditors, road safety auditors come in, right from the first day of the design. As you design, road auditor goes out to the field and certify it as fit, and then approve it for construction.
Right. And so we might just say for Engineer Lowell, these are the kinds of provisions you could make in your budgetary setting.
Ambulance system suggested here, as well as discouraging people against drunk driving. So there will be need for equipment support to ensure that that arrival handling police is effectively implemented and enforced. So I want to suggest that the Road Safety Commission should forward their proposals on this through the Office of Secretary to the Government of the Federation on this, so that these beautiful ideas can be considered in the implementation plan of the economic program. Thank you.
Right, thank you, Engineer. Well. Well, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we've had a number of the discussions draw attention to some salient points in the attempt or in the effort to achieve the goals of the UN Decade of Action for Road Safety in Africa, as in general, and particularly in Nigeria. But we do have here the Minister of State, Bob Watson-Housing, and as we do know in Nigeria, this agency, this government organ, has the entire government of Nigerian rules under its purview. And at this event, Adam Suleiman Hassan is sitting in for the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Professor Lemi Osinbajo. So at this point, we will now call upon the Vice President's representative, the Honorable Minister of State, Bob Watson-Housing, Suleiman Hassan, to deliver the Vice President's address on this occasion, which hopefully will address all the issues that have been raised here in the lecture and in the presentations by the discussants.
Our guest speaker, the special representative of the United Nations Secretary, members of the National Assembly here present, members of the Federal Executive Council here present, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, SANGCON, conveys his warm felicitations to you. We would have loved to be here with you, but it's another important state assignment. So his address to this seventh annual lecture series organized by the Federal Road Safety Group was like this. Let me congratulate management and staff of the Federal Road Safety Group on this occasion of the seventh edition of the FRC annual lecture series. The event demonstrates further commitment of Nigeria to issues of road safety and resolve of federal government to tackle the menace associated with road traffic crashes through deep-rooted discourse and enlightenment programs. The vision behind the establishment of the FRC as Nigeria's lead agency for road safety administration and safety management through the lofty heights attained since its establishment 29 years ago has been vindicated. Today, the menace of road traffic crashes still remains a source of concern, not only to the country, but most developing economies of the world, as evidenced by the attention that road safety is currently attracting from the General Assembly of the United Nations. At the first global conference on road safety held in Moscow, Russia in 2009, member states of the United Nations represented at the meeting agreed on the need to dedicate the next decade to road safety with focus on campaigns against menace of road traffic crashes. The decade's goals were set to involve massive participation of government, non-governmental organizations, communities, religious and traditional institutions, as well as the media, on how to contain the menace. The declaration of 2011 to 2020 as a decade of action for road safety by the United Nations General Assembly in 2010 was therefore the most audacious demonstration of the commitment of the world body to tackling the challenges which road traffic crashes pose to mankind. Consequently, member states were enjoined to evolve adequate policies and programs that would result into the attainment of the campaign goals for the reduction of road traffic crashes, death and injuries to 50% within the campaign period and beyond. It is gratifying to know that Nigeria, as an active member of the United Nations, has been unrelenting in its commitment to fighting the scourge of road traffic crashes in the country and the West African sub-region through involvement of various measures. Aside having a road safety lead agency saddled with the responsibility of ensuring safer roads environments with full legislative powers and autonomy of enforcement, Nigeria was the first nation in Africa and the African continent to activate the UNDK campaign in 2010 under the auspices of the Federal Road Safety Corps, which sets the roadmap for the attainment of the goals. The FRC annual lecture series inaugurated some years back forms part of the nation's activities aimed at creating public awareness on issues of road safety among various stakeholders. Accordingly, Nigeria is grateful that this year's edition of the lecture series is being delivered by no less a personality than the United Nations Secretary General's Special Envoy on Road Safety, Mr. Jean Todd. It is a demonstration of the commitment of the United Nations to the campaigns to make the world roads free from the menace of road traffic crashes. Since its inception, the annual lecture has been attracting huge local and international participation from road safety stakeholders, experts, government institutions, communities, religious and traditional leadership, as well as the media as a platform for discussing issues of road safety. It is our hope that this edition will be utilized to share valuable information on road safety and the way forward on how to achieve the goals of the UN Decade of Action for Road Safety 2011 to 2020, not only in Nigeria, but African continent and the world at large. Let me state that part of Nigeria's commitment to the successes of the UN Road Safety campaign is continuous and expanding scope of legislative reviews of the laws setting up FRC to enhance its capacity for enforcement and boosting competencies of its personnel through capacity development initiatives, as well as massive logistic support by the federal government. I had the privilege of inaugurating the National Road Safety Advisory Council early this year after the federal government gave approval to the strategy document to drive road safety campaigns in the country. I wish to assure members of the international community that Nigeria remains committed to UN campaigns to address the challenges of road safety, not only within the country, but the West African sub-region and African continent at large through adoption of international best practices in road safety management. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as the largest black nation in the world with highest number of vehicular traffic, Nigeria is conscious of the fact that like other developing economies of the world, it is challenged by the menace of road traffic crashes and its negative consequences. Let me, however, restate the nation's commitment to addressing the challenges head-on. Conscious of the fact that over 1.29 million people fall victims of road traffic crashes every year on the world's road, ironically, developing countries like Nigeria account for disproportionate share of the number of victims. The federal government of Nigeria will therefore leave no stone unturned in its readiness to take in appropriate measures that could address the menace. That is why we are evolving policies and programs capable of making Nigeria as a leading example of what a road safety friendly nation should be, not only within the African continent, but the world at large. For the avoidance of doubt, we have in the last 2 years increased the capital and overhead budgetary allocations to the FRSC to make it function more efficiently, provided massive logistics to the core, approved the implementation of the policy on the incorporation of road safety education into the nation's school curriculum. Federal government is also supporting policy on use of crash helmet by cyclists, use of seat belts by motorists, and setting up national speed limits to control the menace of speeding by drivers. It is imperative to know that the inauguration of the National Road Safety Advisory Council was to ensure implementation of the Nigerian Road Safety Strategy document and in furtherance of our commitment road safety initiatives in Nigeria. In the same vein, training and retraining of officers of the Corps at the various institutions at home and abroad to prepare them adequately for the task of carrying out their statutory responsibilities on the roads continue to enjoy the support of government. This is expected to make Nigeria to be at par with global best practices in road safety management and administration. Furthermore, I have taken personal interest in the road safety activities in the country and constantly shared my vision of the FRC with the Corps Marshal. I am glad to know that he has been implementing the ideas with resounding success as evidenced by the record of recognition given to the Corps by local and international institutions. For instance, the World Bank has judged FRSC as the best example of a road safety lead agency. A series of requests have been received by Nigeria from member states of ECOWAS, which constitutes West African Road Safety Organizations for technical assistance in setting up Nigeria's model of road safety lead agency in their countries. Let me reiterate that as a leading nation in Africa with Eurocentric foreign policy objectives, the federal government of Nigeria will continue to render necessary support to the FRC to make it possible for it to extend such assistance to neighboring countries in Africa. Save them from threats of road carnage. I must, however, state that keeping the record safe is not a responsibility. Keeping the road safe is not a responsibility which all government citizens are successfully handled, except with the support of all citizens and stakeholders who must join hands in the spirit of shared responsibility. Accordingly, I call on all stakeholders, state governments, law enforcement agencies, transport unions, organized private sector, non-governmental organization, and civil society groups to rally around FRSC in its task of making the roads safer for all. At this juncture, let me particularly commend the World Bank for its collaborative initiatives in Nigeria, especially in the same corridor project and some selected roads across the country. The project is a success story, and the federal government hopes to replicate it on more roads. To this end, let me call on all the participants visiting Nigeria for the first time to explore the beauty and hospitality of the people of Nigeria and its beautiful city, which serves as the nation's federal capital. It is our pleasure to welcome all tourists and businessmen and women from across the globe to explore the business opportunities and tourist attractions that abound in the country, especially now that the country has successfully improved on the ease of doing business. Once again, welcome the guest speaker, Mr. Jean Todd, members of his entourage, and participants to this 7th edition of the FRSC. insights into the challenges of road safety in Africa and how to achieve the goals of UNDP of Action for Road Safety 2011 to 2020. I assure you that the federal government of Nigeria will study the resolutions reached at this meeting and give expeditious considerations to the implementation in our commitments to achieving greater safety for Nigerian roads. Finally, I wish you all a safe return to your various destinations. Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much. That was the address of the Vice President, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, delivered there by the Minister of State for Power, Works and Housing, Suleiman Hassan. Now, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the Deputy Co-Marshal of Operations, DCM, Jemma Ekwun, and thank you all for attending this lecture.
Dear Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, here representing the Minister of State Works, on behalf of the Corps Marshal Federation of the Corps, officers and men of the Corps, we want to sincerely thank you all for coming. We want to thank the Minister of State for being here personally. We thank the Acting Secretary of Government for being here with us. We want to thank His Imperial Majesty, the Union, for taking very much for coming. I want to thank my special guest, Ajitor, coming in all the way from America. Thank you for coming. We thank our first chairman, Professor Wolisho Ikpan. He came in last night and thought it was expedient to see how his children are doing. Thank you very much for coming. We want to thank all our guests, former chairman, Professor Marshall, officers and men, wives of officers, associations, presidents and members, special marshals, that the first chairman has told us at the backbone of the Federal Road Safety, that is community policing in the road safety. We want to thank all our guest officers and men, and we hope that whenever we call on you, we're here. But above all of that, I hope that as we live here, what will resonate with us is that road safety is a shared responsibility and that with our attitude, we can change the situation. Thank you very much for coming. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, this is just about it, but as we round off, I would just like to acknowledge here that a number of past chairmen of the FRSA have kept the faith with this organization, and we need to acknowledge them and thank them for all the support of the years. We already acknowledged Professor Wolisho Ikpan. Let me quickly recognize as well Vice Admiral Akin Duo. Thank you so much, sir. And Oji Maina Waziri, who's also chair of this board, has been here with us. Same thing, Mr. Greg, by the way, who is here as well. And of course, Mr. Felix Chukwu, who is all past chairman of the board of FRSC and is still part of the family. Thank you very much for attending this lecture. Just a quick announcement that immediately after this, tea and some snacks. And just to acquaint you with the arrangements for that, those seated by my right, special guests here, and of course those on the first front row, we have a guest room where they can have their tea and snacks. For the other guests, adequate provision has been made just behind this hall. Just a quick reminder that all personnel of the FRSC are enjoined to stay back and allow the guests have their tea and snacks before they go for theirs. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen, and now Mr. Chairman, and of course, the representative of the Vice President.
Thank you very much. And just before we leave, once more.
Festive period. What's your advice to the motorists?
My advice to the motorists, not only my member alone, you should remember you have no spare hand. Drive with care. Drive with care and let love it. Love yourself and love others. Don't increase transport because of the festival. Because the people we are carrying our brothers, our in-laws, and we should continue maintain that accordant relationship. No increment to transport.
Alright, what lesson are you taking home on this program?
No, it's a good lesson. We have a document. We are going to discuss with our members in the meeting that this is what they discuss here. We must key into it and take it as a part of duty to work with.
Thank you very much, sir.
And God bless you.